here redox reaction na na redox reaction or else we can also call oxidation reduction reaction. Here in this redox reaction means oxidation and reduction reaction both takes place simultaneously in one reaction. Okay, only in one chemical equation simultaneously oxidation and reduction reaction takes place. So see here, definition: a reaction involving both oxidation and reduction simultaneously is called redox reaction or oxidation reduction reaction. Here in redox reaction, one reactant gets oxidized, that means reducing agent, and other gets reduced, oxidizing agent. Okay, one reactant gets oxidized as a reducing agent and other gets reduced as oxidizing agent. So here seen an example. When you see the example, you'll get understood. CuO plus H2 gives rise to Cu plus H2O given here. On the reactant side, we are taken copper oxide and hydrogen gas here. But on the product side, what we got? Copper and H2O. Yes? See here. Can anyone tell which is oxidation and which is reduction in this? Yes.
H2O is oxidation reaction.
Okay, H2 to H2O is oxidation reaction, and
CuO to Cu is reduction reaction.
Yeah, very good. Very good. Here, CuO to Cu is reduction reaction because we removed oxygen from copper oxide. We got copper finally. So that is a reduction reaction, and H2 to H2O we got. So addition of oxygen here takes place, right? So that's why this is a oxidation reaction. So here both are takes place simultaneously in this reaction. So we can call this as a redox reaction or oxidation reduction reaction. In the second example also, here we have Fe2O3 and carbon on the reactant side, right? Product side we got Fe and CO2. Here oxygen is removed from iron and it is added to the carbon. So here Fe2O3 to Fe is reduction and C2CO2 is oxidation. So this is also one of the example to redox reaction. Yes, tell me here in third example, which is oxidation, which is reduction? Kartikeya?
The 2B reduction, CO2 oxidation.
So we have to tell here PbO2 Pb is reduction. Your audio. And C2CO2 oxidation. So redox reaction. Okay, PbO2 Pb is reduction and C2CO2 oxidation reaction. So both are takes place simultaneously in this. So this is one of the example to redox reaction. Redox reaction, or else we can also call oxidation reduction reaction. So one is reducing agent, one is oxidizing agent. So don't confuse with this, Nana. You may get a doubt here in oxidizing and reducing agent. Reducing agent means an oxidation process. Oxidizing agent means reduction process. That's it. Yes, are you understood up to here? Any doubts, anyone? Yes, all of you.
No, teacher.
Okay. Next, we have effects of oxidation in daily life. Okay, see, corrosion. First one is here, corrosion. What is meant by corrosion? Yes, what is meant by corrosion?
Tuppu pattadam.
Okay, good. Okay, how the corrosion will form? And on which materials corrosion will form? On which substances or on which materials? On which objects?
Iron.
Only iron?
Metals.
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 What about non-metals? What about this pen?
No, teacher.
It gets rusted or not?
No, teacher.
Why?
Not reacts with atmosphere oxygen.
Not reacts with atmospheric oxygen. Okay. Then metals. What about metals? You are saying metals gets rusted. Yes, metals react with atmospheric oxygen, so that's why metals gets rusted. Atmospheric oxygen means in that moisture will be present in atmospheric air, so then only the objects, the metals gets rusted, or otherwise not. If moisture is not there, the objects will not get rust. If only oxygen is there, there is no moisture, the metals get will not get rust. Okay, if only moisture is there, oxygen is not there, then also the metals get will not get rust. Only air unna ante only oxygen unna moisture lekapoyina dry oxygen undu anukundam ikkada rust ane form avadu. Only manaki moisture maatrame undi ikkada air em ledu appudu kuda rust ane form avadu. ఒక బీకర్ లో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వి ఆర్ టేకెన్ 3 బీకర్స్ ఇన్ 3 బీకర్స్ వి ఆర్ టేకెన్ వాటర్ ఇన్ 3 బీకర్స్ వి ఆర్ టేకెన్ వాటర్ ఓకే ఇన్ 3 బీకర్స్ వి ఆర్ టేకెన్ ఐరన్ నేల్ assume that this is iron nail. Okay, in all we have water now. Okay, in one beaker you pour some oil. Okay, and okay, take one beaker as empty only with completely air without any moisture. Close this one. Now in one beaker take water, just water. So here in one beaker you are taken oil and water with iron nail, and in one beaker you are taken iron nail and just air is there, in that no moisture is there, only dry air is there, and in another beaker you are taken water and iron nail. So here in which beaker iron nail gets rusted after some days?
Third one.
Why?
It have oxygen and moisture.
It has oxygen and moisture, right? So here in first beaker we are taken oil. So here oil will not allow the air into inside of the water. That is works as a layer here. So that layer will not allow the air inside of the water. So that's why that iron nail will not get rust. And here in the second beaker, just dry air is there. There is no moisture in that air. So that's why that iron nail also does not get rust here. And in the third beaker, we are taken water and iron nail. We open that one simply. So here, that iron nail reacts with atmospheric oxygen. And already moisture is there in that. So easily this iron nail gets rusted here. So to form rust on the metals. So that object reacts with air and moisture. Okay, so here deterioration of a metal in presence of air and moisture is called corrosion. Okay, air undali, moisture undali, rust anedi form avvali anante.